The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you,
Lord. As Jesus passed by, two blind men followed him, crying out, "Son of David, have pity on us." When he entered the house, the blind men approached him, and Jesus said to them, "Do you believe that I can do this?" "Yes, Lord," they said to him. Then he touched their eyes, and he said, "Let it be done for you according to your faith." And their eyes were opened. Jesus warned them sternly, "See that no one knows about this." But they went out and spread the word of him throughout all that land. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we journey on our pilgrimage and we journey through the season of Advent, we come to Friday of the first week of Advent and we reflect upon God's word that speaks to us about how there will be a fruitful, the orchard will be changed into a forest, and the forest be regarded as beautiful. And all of that then that the blind shall see. In the gospel passage, we hear about the two blind men who are healed by our Lord. They're crying out for mercy, for pity, and they are healed. And the Lord says, "Don't let anyone know about this." Many times that causes confusion for people to hear that Jesus says, "Don't tell anybody about this." And yet, oftentimes, what needs to be understood in that is that the people of the world of Jesus' time were expecting a different kind of a Messiah, expecting some Messiah to come in and defeat the Romans, expecting a Messiah who was going to be triumphant, and all of this. And Jesus was a suffering servant Messiah, one who through his suffering would take away our sins and give us a share in eternal life. So he tells them not to tell anything that's false because their understanding was not true. And really, even though they had their eyes open physically, their spiritual eyes hadn't quite gotten to that point. During the Advent season, we ask the Lord to help us to open our spiritual eyes, to prepare for his coming. That we ask him often to help us to be alert to his presence in the Word of God, his presence in the Eucharist, but also his presence around us in our daily lives, even in those that we meet. And we come today, we pause on this pilgrimage to come to this Church of Blessed Sebastian Aparisi. And I've just recently learned a little bit about him. Actually, there's a, I think it would be worth a quick little brief review of his life here. Briefly, it says in 1502 he was born, and he left his home at the age of 20 and went to travel to Iraq and Salamanca, and then where he works as a butler. And Sebastian filled up wishes to travel to the New World. 11 years later, he came to Veracruz. And so he was born in Spain, and now he comes to Veracruz, where he stayed for a short period. And he wanted to come to Puebla. And a few years later, he came to Puebla, and he opened and transformed ways and roads. He opened paths from Mexico to Veracruz, spreading it out here to Zacatecas. And he bought two country states, and he worked in his country states, improving the Christian virtues learned.
to the nuns and the poor, and achieved by his hard work of 39 years, received the habit of the novitiate at the age of 72 years. And then he reached the important state of his life when he was admitted to the monastery, and eventually he is ordained a priest. And he dies at the age of 98, 5 months after the date when there was the finding of the body of Sebastian, when they found it. And they, when they discovered his body some years later, they discovered that it was incorrupt. And so we gather here to this church where there's this special recognition of this saint who blessed as opposed to one way to saint. And he's blessed and he worked on Rome, physical Rome. But I think he also spent a little bit of time out on the road living the gospel. We're called to do that as we go on our way, even on this pilgrimage or on other ways, to go and to speak to others and to live the faith and to help them to know the Lord and to know the gospel, to let his light shine through us. In Advent, we reflect upon the light of the world that's coming in, and we reflect on how our sin darkens that light. And the collect of the Mass, we pray, stir up your power, O Lord, and come. Stir up that power in us, that with you to protect us, we may find a rescue from the pressing dangers of our sins. In one of the earlier stops of one of the chapels, we reflected a little bit on our sins and how our sins offend God. And We pray for the rescue from the pressing dangers of sin, and that with you to set us free, we may be found worthy of salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. And one thing I ask, one thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Yes, to dwell in his house in eternity in heaven, but even to pause at various times on our journey to be in his house, reflect on his love for us and to continue to proclaim him by what we do, even if it's making roads, or whatever is our occupation, as well as by our prayers, to lead others closer to Christ, who is the light of the world.